الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الحمد لله الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى الحمد لله الواحد الأحد الفرد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يتخذ صاحبة ولا ولدا نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ به من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا يا رب لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك آمنا بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبمحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم هاديا ورسولا ونصلي ونسلم على سيدنا وحبيبنا وعظيمنا وقائدنا محمد بن عبد الله صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه بعثه الله رحمة للعالمين مبشرا ونذيرا وداعيا إليه بإذنه وسراجا وهاجا وقمرا منيرا فهدى به الله الأمة وكشف به عنها الغمة فجزاه الله خير ما جزى نبيا من أنبيائه. Dear brothers, though theoretically a lot of us think of Allah being the merciful, practically we more think of Him being the humiliator, the punisher, the one who's waiting for you to sin, to trip, to make a mistake, and He will get hold of you and not leave you. If you have been educated on the manners and educations of Islam, and you are not a teenager, you're not a very young Muslim, then maybe the principles have been slowly set in yourself, and you are more capable of understanding and fathom the principles behind life and the creation and the purpose of us, our existence on the face of earth. Yet, when we come to explain to our teenagers and young people who live a life not the way we lived, not the way we've been educated, it is very difficult to convey this principle of the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal when they go through so many difficulties in their life. Unfortunately, not only for the public, but also for the elect. Some of the da'iyin who have channels on social media, when they come to do tafsir, sometimes they confuse rather than clarify these concepts. The concept of mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal. I quote in a latest session that I've watched on YouTube, Jazallah Khair, the interpreters were saying, at the heart of the relationship with Allah is testing and tribulation. أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يَفْتُنُونَ. Did people thought that it is enough for them to say, we believe and they will not be tested? That's one ayah that he brought into to support his speech. The second one, he said, لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي كَبَدٍ. Truly, we have created human being in exhaustive labor. كَبَدٍ. So, where is the ease? Where is the mercy? Where is... And the third one he brought, belief in Allah is there not to solve our problems. Now, these sentences may be, if they are put in the right context and in the right argument, you may be able to find the justification. But the whole session I watched, and for a young person or a teenager, he will be completely confused. Now, if you tell this to the despair, that, by the way, if you believe in Allah Azza wa Jal, that's not going to solve your problems. You're going to live a hardship. Your life is going to be difficult. But you still have to believe. Tell this to the despair, to the sinner, to the heavily loaded disobedient. Tell this to the depressed, to the desperate who's about to commit suicide, to the disbelievers, to the agnostics who are looking, trying to find an answer about is there a God or is there not. When they come to study the literature, unfortunately the interpretation of what we created around Quran, probably that would repel them away from Allah, from the concept of Allah. Or at least it would repel them away from the religion of mercy, Deen al-Rahma al-Islam. Now, I declare this is all wrong. If anything, Quran has to be read in its entirety. It has to be understood in its entirety. Every verse has to be understood in its own context. And that's very important. Yeah. The very well-established, deep-rooted scholars who've spoken about these issues, when you read in their works, they all agree that the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal is the principle that Islam as a religion promotes. Allah Azza wa Jal is the merciful. Shaitan likes this confusion. He likes this confusion and he's determined he will make those who are weak or those who are confused fall into despair. And as narrated in the Quran, Yaqub alayhi salam likened the despair, al-ya's, with the kufr. Ya bunayya dhhabu fatahassas, ya bunayya dhhabu fatahassasu min Yusuf wa akhih, wa la tayasu min rawhillahi, innahu la yayasu min rawhillahi illa al-qawmun kafirun. Never give up hope of God's soothing mercy. Truly, no one despairs of God's soothing mercy except those who have no faith. Now, if we take these grim interpretations and the outlook to Allah and to life, then what does the following ayahs mean? Allah Azza wa Jalla says in Quran, من عمل صالحا من ذكر أو أنثى وهو مؤمن فلنحيينه حياة طيبة. Whoever does righteousness, whether male or female, while he is a believer, we will surely cause him to live a good life. That's a statement. That's an eternal statement. ألا إن أولياء الله لا خوف عليهم ولا يحزنون ولا هم يحزنون. Unquestionably, for the allies of Allah, أولياء الله, there will be no fear concerning them, nor they will grieve. That's another statement. Also, يا أيها الذين آمنوا استجيبوا لله وللرسول إذا دعاكم لما يحييكم. All you who believe, respond to Allah and to the Messenger when He calls you to that which gives you life. And the Mufassirun says life as in good life. A life that you are content and happy in it. In a hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in al-Bukhari, whoever would like his provision to be abundant and his lifespan to be extended, let him uphold his ties with kinship. So you do some of the good deeds and Allah Azza wa Jal will ease for you, bring bounties to you, and not only that, but also prolong your life as well by connecting with the kin. So there are things that if we follow, we stick for, life is not a hardship. And Allah, when we believe in Allah Azza wa Jal, it's not like our problems will not be solved. Allah created all this universe and the earth, the stars and everything to facilitate life for us, the human beings. He honored us. He, subhanahu wa ta'ala, honored us and gave us a rank over his other creations. Now, إن الذين قالوا ربنا الله ثم استقاموا تتنزل عليهم الملائكة ألا تخافوا ولا تحزنوا وأبشروا بالجنة التي كنتم توعدون. Indeed, those who said our Lord is Allah and then remained on a right course, the angels will descend upon them saying, do not fear and do not grieve, but receive good tidings, paradise, which you were promised. But when we believe in Allah Azza wa Jal, and go through the life, Allah Azza wa Jal, by default, has created us to mercy us and to live in happiness. But to feel the happiness, we have to work for it. There is no meaning of Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, creating and forcing happiness on us on the face of earth. The condition to live in this life is that He's given us the choice. Al-khayar, He's given us the choice. Many of us choose the right path, and as a result, we'll be included in the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal, and we will live a happy life, and some of us sometimes are misguided. And as a result, they will see some straighteners. The tribulations, tests, punishments, all of this is a big topic. Maybe inshallah in the future we talk about this in its context. But today, I'm here to talk about the glad tidings that Allah is the merciful and Islam is the religion of mercy. The evidence for all of that is in the Quran, and this is this ayah in Surah Hud, verse 118-119, is a principle rule about the purpose of existence. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَوْ شَاءَ رَبُّكَ لَجَعَلَ النَّاسَ أُمَّةً وَاحِدَةً وَلَا يَزَالُونَ مُخْتَلِفِينَ إِلَّا مَنْ رَحِمَ رَبُّكَ وَلِذَلِكَ خَلَقَهُمْ. And if your Lord had willed, He could have made mankind one community, i.e. He would have forced us to live in a same way, to just not to have the choice to believe or disbelieve, to live in one way. But He, in His wisdom, subhanahu wa ta'ala, has given us the choice. And that's why you will have variation. Some of us will stick to the guidance and some will deviate. It's part of the wisdom of Allah Azza wa Jal to live this life. You will not feel happiness unless you worked, you choose it. Unless you worked for it and you choose it. So, if you choose the right path, you are included in the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal. And the condition to that is the free will. Dear brothers, a Western philosopher, a thinker, Thomas Paine, said, "Belief in a cruel God makes a cruel man." And I do not need to elaborate on this. A lot of what's going on in our areas, unfortunately, though many of us believe, yeah, there are some outside interventions and so on, unfortunately, some of these cruel messages, some of our people do carry it. In their psyche, in their mind, Allah Azza wa Jal is more the humiliator, more the punisher, more the forceful one than the merciful, than the compassionate, than the oft forgiven. And that's why you see the lots of killing all in the name of the religion of mercy. It's enough to see, to know that by studying the Muslims' book, Quran, that there are over 200 verses that talks about the Rahmah and its derivatives in Quran. While the ayat of al-adab, the verses of punishment and tribulations, talks about only 17 ayah, 200 to 17, yeah? And some ignorance would want to believe that they call their YouTube channels the sword of Allah, the wiper of the falsehood, the soldier, and all of these images that does not convey the true portrait of Islam as being the religion of mercy. Enough for us to know that Allah Azza wa Jalla stated, وَرَحْمَتِي وَسِعَتْ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. And some of us would like to believe that this rahmah is only included to the believers. But if we study the following hadith as narrated about Sayyidina Ibrahim, when an old man visited him and said, Ibrahim used to be Abu Dhifan, he used to be very generous and offer food. And then Ibrahim said, Bismillah, let's eat. And the man said, what are you saying? I don't know what you're talking about. He said, Bismillah, the one who created. The old man said, I don't know who your Lord, who you're talking about. Ibrahim expelled him. Allah straight away sent the angel Jibreel to say, oh Ibrahim, I've been feeding him for the last 70 years. And he was disobeying me and I did not expel him out of my mercy. Yet from one night, one meal, and he refused to believe in what you're believing in, you expel him. So this concept in our minds, we need to humble ourselves. The rahmah of Allah Azza wa Jal includes and extends to everything. When Allah says shay, a thing, it means a thing. If you think anybody on the face of earth is a thing, he is included in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, نَبِّ عِبَادِي أَنِّي أَنَا الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ وَأَنَّ عَذَابِي هُوَ الْعَذَابُ الْأَلِيمُ. Orders the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to say, tell them, I am the merciful, I am the forgiving. And then he described his action, the punishment, as being harmful, severe. So he called himself the merciful, forgiven, but some of his actions in its suitable context in Quran is being described as severe. A Bedouin came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, who's gonna be in charge of the accounting on the day of judgment? And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah. The Bedouin said, by himself? He said, yes, by himself. The Bedouin smiled. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, why are you smiling? He said, when the most generous is in a position to punish, he forgives. And when he brings to account, he pardons. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said, glad tidings, by Allah, the one who is no God but him, Allah Azza wa Jal will forgive. A forgiveness on the day of judgment that will not come to the imagination of any of us. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم. I would like to end, alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalam ala rasulillah. I would like to end with this beautiful hadith Qudusi, inshallah. Allah says, O son of Adam, as long as you call upon me and put your hope in me, I have forgiven you for what you have done, and I do not mind. O son of Adam, if your sins were to reach the clouds of the sky, and then you would seek my forgiveness, I would forgive you. O son of Adam, if you were to come to me with sins that are close to filling the earth, then you would meet me without ascribing any partners with me. I would certainly bring to you forgiveness close to filling it. عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون وأقموا الصلاة